Vojtěch Sommer, a Czech triathlete, received a 4-year doping ban for using recombinant EPO. However, the data that convicted him is less than convincing. Four accomplished molecular biologists independently reviewed the A and B sample documentation provided by two WADA-accredited laboratories. They concluded from the data provided that there's no scientific evidence that proves the presence of recombinant EPO in Sommer's urine. To detect EPO, the laboratory used an SDS page test, which is then compared against positive and negative results. Highlighted in red is Sommer's sample. The darkest bands are naturally occurring EPO. The shadow above, marked in blue, is what the laboratory claims is the banned substance REPO. The laboratory used software to visualize these results with a line graph. In order to identify a specific protein, the sample must align with the positive control. Here is the athlete's sample. Here is a positive control. There is obvious variation on the relevant upper half. Look, however, at the athlete's sample when compared to the negative control. The lines are almost identical except for this small shoulder. So, why something is there? Because it does not match the positive control, the results are inconclusive. Which two graphs are most similar? The athlete sample as compared to the negative control? Or to the positive control?
Now, Sommer's sample doesn't really show anything up here. Yet he was sanctioned. And this is because there is a shadow of something up here. And we have argued, this group I mentioned earlier, that this band is not where recombinant EPO is. And he was charged with taking recombinant EPO. This cannot be recombinant EPO. That's no way. If it is recombinant EPO, there's something seriously wrong with our assay.
Two proteins are not identical if they do not migrate with the same speed and thus position differently. The protein that the laboratory claims is REPO has not been positively identified, but is possibly due to the tailing or spreading of natural EPO, which is typical and can be seen in the other negative controls. From these results, there is no evidence that Vojtěch Sommer used REPO. The laboratory's treatment of the analysis is superficial, and illustrated again that all too many WADA-accredited laboratories produce suboptimal work that falls short of quality standards. Such behavior clearly jeopardizes the rights of athletes.
I think I can say that it destroyed my life, and not just in my life, and it destroyed my life of my sparring partner, because he stopped with training to the triathlon after that happened to me, and it destroyed a club where I was training, because everyone in the club just stopped with the training for the triathlon after that. So it's not destroy just me, it destroy my friends, my family, and my team.
This is the third doping case involving EPO that has been questioned by this independent group of biologists, who are only asking for discussion in the interest of good science. If WADA laboratories cannot enter open scientific debate about results, the consequences are indeed troubling.